find the notion strange that I should respect someone's opinion more if they had military experience, if they were brainwashed by the military to do the government's bidding. Nothing against people in the military. They have dedicated their lives to do the bidding of the government, you know, to fight for the government of this country. In most cases, they are totally selfless acts. When I say selfless act, I'm talking about the act of joining the military to try to do something for the good. It doesn't mean that the military is doing good things once they join. Okay, going around killing a bunch of people, I wouldn't say that's selfless. In many others, it's people trying to get grants or scholarships for higher education, mostly because many of them don't have any other means. You know, and there are also the people out there who join the military just so they can shoot things and kill people and blow things up and that sort of thing. So, I mean, I can't say that those people don't exist. They're there. So, just like when it comes to, there's a number of people who become police officers just so they can have power over other people. So, but no matter how selfless the act, it doesn't make their opinions any more important than anyone else's. At least, not unless they're talking about things related to the military. Being in the military doesn't make your opinions about social issues, current events, and politics any more important than anyone else's. It should have a chance to be heard just like everyone else, but it doesn't deserve special treatment. I think about how there are still so many people out there who look up to the military as some sort of a force to teach boys how to be real men, right? Almost as a continuation of the Boy Scouts, and the Boy Scouts is obviously very religious. I was a Boy Scout, I know. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duties to God and my country and to obey the Scout law. Trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, brave, thrifty, clean, and reverent. Oh, joy. Yeah, young men feeling like they need to come to military standards in order to be masculine, you know, or real men, is far harsher than the standards that are often pushed from their peers in public schools. I don't think military recruiters should be allowed on school property. But I guess part of the No Child Left Behind Act was guaranteeing that the military has that kind of access. Oh joy. The whole real man thing is probably one of the biggest reasons why people freaked out so much over the notion, you know, in the beginning anyway, over the notion of freely allowing gay men to be in the military. It was the fear that it would interfere with a masculine military archetype, you know, with a false assumption that gay men are feminine by default. That, and they didn't want the chance of being sexually harassed and sexually assaulted by other men. And we can see that wasn't really much of a problem, but still, that was their fears. It's kind of strange. Right now, China is trying to clamp down on feminine men. They're making it illegal to have feminine men on television. And there's a whole bunch of other things. It's kind of weird. Sorry, I kind of digressed for a moment. So yeah, when it comes to social issues, politics, or current events, I'm not going to put those who have served in the military up higher than anyone else, really. I'll thank them for their service, but they don't automatically deserve a bigger voice unless they're talking about things military-related, because they know what they're talking about, right? A common thread in rightward thinking is that if you put on a huge act as if you're really, really patriotic, make it look like you absolutely adore the military and the culture behind it, and if it's not the military, it's the police that you should show absolute admiration of, you know, or both. Like, almost as if you have an altar dedicated to law enforcement and the military. You know, that sort of thing makes you more patriotic than other people. And if you're more patriotic, well, that means that your opinion is worth more than other people's. Are you more patriotic? Maybe.
Are you talking about my vagina?
Maybe.
Maybe not. But who cares? It doesn't mean you should be listened to any more than anyone else. You hate the progressive stack, yet you want preferential treatment and think that you deserve to be listened to more just because you strive to be more stoic, patriotic, and masculine than everyone else. You know, those things don't get you any extra points. So yeah, there's a lot of right-wing social commentators on YouTube and a number of other places who do this very thing. Similar to how people like to show off their Funko Pop collection in the background to, you know, build a camaraderie with the fans, right? With the fans that like that same thing. Or how people like to put up DC or Marvel memorabilia and posters all over the place in the background in order to either look badass or to just, you know, impress the fans. Oh, look, look, they like the same things we like. Which is fine. I'm not, people have their thing, you know, whatever. You like that? I like other things. So, you know, whatever. Or like how the quartering puts Pokemon behind him to impress, But what you're really supposed to do if you're patriotic is put a flag behind you. Make sure you have a lot of symbols around that represent freedom and liberty. You know, maybe even have some books on the shelf, on the bookshelf, that you can clearly see from far away that they have the words liberty and freedom in them. You know, I don't know, maybe have a copy of the Constitution somewhere. You know, have it on the wall or something, you know, next to the flag. You know, maybe have a sword, a little miniature sword and shield or something somewhere, you know, on the bookshelf as well, right? You know, but you try to make it look like this is your professional place to do your patriotic research. I mean, if YouTube allowed it, a lot of people would probably put all their firearms, their whole firearm collection they'd have sitting in the background, right? You know, right next to their flags, you know, in order to look more patriotic and powerful. Because, you know, powerful, that's patriotism. But all of this stuff is very effective, especially effective if someone obviously looks like they spend a lot of time at the gym and they really, really want to show it off. Who? Real patriot! Patriot! Okay, wait, that's kind of over the top or whatever, but seriously, it's anything to present this image that they're ready for a brawl, that they're a badass, right? And that automatically makes their opinions more important to listen to, right? Definitely more important than a soy boy liberal feminine man, right? You know, people should automatically be given extra respect for being hyper-masculine. Because masculinity is under attack, so we have to become hyper-masculine to show that they're right or something. There are reasons why I choose to have a neutral backdrop instead of, you know, like setting up some sort of a scene. You know, I try not to even show any brands on my clothing. Oh, look, it's a Levi's shirt or something like that. This I just recently removed the name brand from it off of it. I took it off. It's just like, yeah, I don't need to be displaying that. You know, and I generally wear t-shirts of, just plain t-shirts of assorted colors. A lot of times they're white because I have 12 of them, so. But, you know, besides not wanting people to see how messy I am, it's because I don't want people to feel like, oh, I can relate with you because we both like these products. Ooh, I like that same corporate franchise as you do. I'm not visually trying to present myself as anything but me. I'm not trying to appear patriotic. I'm not trying to appear as a nerd or a geek, or that I support a company, or that I collect a bunch of things. Or present myself as a gamer. I just want to present myself as me. You know, if I then fit into any of those categories, fine, so be it. It's just not something I go out of my way to present myself as, though. I'm just me. I'm not a bunch of symbols. I'm not a set of virtues. I'm just a person with opinions on the internet. So when people show me these right-wing videos where they're doing this whole hyper-masculine, hyper-nationalist thing with all these corny mannerisms and attitudes and fripperies, you know, like they're ready to brawl, it's really hard for me to watch. I can handle the smugness from people like Bill Whittle far more than I can people who constantly have to prove how masculine, patriotic, and stoic they are. I find it interesting that some of these same people who build their entire identity around how stoic and patriotic and masculine they are complain about those who base their identity off of where they fit in the LGBT spectrum. You know, one type of identity politics is bad, but these others over here are just fine. You know, identity politics are great when you base them on patriotism and masculinity, with patriotism meaning that you stand 100% with law enforcement and all the culture behind it, and most of the military occupations across the globe, at least when we've had a Republican president. Unless, of course, law enforcement enforces things that you don't think should be enforced, and then it's authoritarian government overreach it's the left's fault. It has to be. Law enforcement isn't authoritarian unless it's enforcing something that the left believes in, Or, you know, that's the mindset, right? So just for a random thought before I end the video. Out of the Daily Wire, which I don't watch anymore because of that DMCA incident with Michael Knowles, but out of the people on the Daily Wire, I can handle Andrew Klavan the most. He has the most reasonable attitude out of all of them. I may not like most of what he says, but he seems to be the most rational and logical one out of them, you know, as well as wise. Matt Walsh tries to act as though he's the most moral person in existence. He doesn't even think dogs offer love, just neediness. Michael Knowles acts and dresses like a frat boy in a Revenge of the Nerds movie. And Ben Shapiro called Andrew Neil a leftist. Safe paths, and thanks for watching.